Hi, this is GHPK, and today I have a mod for my car. Actually, I have an amplifier and a lot of LEDs installed in my car, so I have to sometime be very cautious about the battery drainage on my car. I searched on the web, like on eBay and Aliexpress and all. So all those sites were selling a pluggable battery monitor. But to my belief, I don't trust those monitors, because if you install it on a cigarette lighter charger output, or you connect it to your stereo or anywhere in your car, that is going to give you the regulated voltage output, because most of the things you connect to your car comes after the 12 volt regulator you have in the ECU and other car electrical circuit. So those things will most of the time show you 12 and maybe 12.5 or a max of 13 volts of output, because that is not coming directly from your alternator. It has a voltage regulator circuit in between. Most people don't know this fact. So to know whether your car is able to charge car battery while it is on the move, you need to install a battery monitor which tells you what is the output your car is able to pump into the battery while it is running. That is the amount of voltage and the current which the alternator is producing while the engine is running. So I ordered this small digital meter. It is a 7-segment based display, and these are very cheap on AliExpress and eBay. You can buy it from many online stores, and it consists of three wires, and this is a yellow colored one. So next thing I was looking for installing this, where do I install this? I don't want it to be dangling like this, so I'm going to remove this dummy button and I'll try to fabricate this into inside of this. And To be able to do that, I'm going to remove this. I already installed a battery monitor. As you can see, I have this white and red LED. Then there is also a green and a blue LED. So these are for these are based on some IC based circuit I made a couple of years back. They basically tell you this is the 11 volt LED, this is the 12 volt LED. The next green will come up when the voltage is 13 volt, and very rarely I find my blue light to come up, which is of 14 volts. So this is a circuit. I'll share the circuit in the description of the video. So I don't want these lights, because these are little bit confusion, and most of the times I am not able to know whether my alternator is able to generate lot of current so that my amp doesn't drain the battery, and next time I'm going to crank up my car, whether I'll be getting 12 volts to be able to juice up the starter motor. So let's fabricate this thing and show you what actually I'm going to do with the voltage monitor for this car. So a little bit of change in my plans. I was planning to install it on this slot, but now I am trying to just install it on this plastic cap, just because while I'm driving, this will not cause me glares or any disturbance, while having on this side will always keep me distracted, or you know, little bit of conscious about the battery voltage, which I shouldn't be while driving. So I feel this is the right spot to install it. So I'm going to remove this like this and cut it and fabricate it so that the voltage meter stays inside of this panel. As you can see, these are the plastic parts which I'll melt and remove, and I'll show you the progress. Used a cutter and removed all the plastic parts from this. Now it is time to dig a hole and make it fit the battery monitor. So I prepared this voltage meter. As you can see, I cut through the plastic part of this dashboard. It was a dummy button, so I made a hole, but unfortunately and due to lack of proper Dremel tool, I cut the hole a little bigger. Then I used the tape to just seal up the required space. I also filled up hot glue. So now I'm going to fix this on the dashboard, and the wire will come all the way from this back of the dashboard to the center console, the gear console. I already have a lot of buttons for various things like existing voltage meter, the inbuilt embedded car charger, and a lot of LED lights. So all are controlled by these switches. I'm going to add another switch on the remaining one of the remaining slot. So once I drill a hole, I fix up a switch which I have prepared. This is the miniature heavy duty switch I'm going to use, and I'll fix this up, run a wire from this console to this switch and from this switch to the voltage meter, and to power up this voltage meter directly from my car alternator, I'm going to use this car amplifier power supply. This is the main power supply, positive power supply. Red one, red wire is coming directly from the bonnet, and it does not have any power regulator. It is just directly connected to the battery positive terminal. So I'm going to hook up the wire for voltage meter onto this, because this will give me the direct reading whatever voltage battery is giving, and during the running of car whatever voltage the alternator is generating to charge the car battery. So I'll have to do some wiring now. As you can see, I've removed the plastic part, the gear, central gear console, and this is the console I have taken out. I already have a lot of stuff inside this. You can see there are switches. There is one existing power monitor. It is a IC based circuit which calculates and compares the voltage and shows me via a LED panel already connected here. And these are the existing buttons, but I have to be very careful because I am going to hook up the car positive wire, and I don't want it to touch with any other existing wire, because the wire I am now connecting is coming directly from the alternator. So that is why I have prepared the switch, and I have used heat shrink tube to protect the parts, insulation tape over it, and make sure I don't touch any other parts. So I am going to install the switch now inside the panel. So I have connected the voltage meter on the panel. Now the wires are running back from the dash. I don't think it is hard necessary to show you the video about how the wire came along. You can already do that. I already have so many of wires, so I know that this one was the ground wire. I hooked up the meter to this ground wire, and the positive wire is going through this hose, plastic hose, to all the way to the switch. From this switch it is going to my amplifier, and I'll just show you the temporary connection meter. Once I turn on the switch, you can see 12.1 volt. My battery is currently charged up to 12.1 volt. So when I'll start this car, this voltage will increase. As this is a yellow color one, it is less glary to the eyes. I have specifically used the yellow color orange one just to avoid any possible distraction while driving. And now I'm going to start the car and show you the difference in the voltage. Car has started. Now I'm going to turn on the key for this monitor. You can see my alternator is delivering 13.8 volts, which is very good. And even if I turn on the blower, my voltage is still 13.5 volts. That means alternator is generating enough voltage and current to charge the battery. Now if I turn on the air conditioning, you can see the voltage dropped just below the 13 volts and then came up. Now air conditioning is on. Now I have turned on the headlights also. You can see it is showing 12.8. Headlights off. Now it is back to 13. Now I'm going to turn off the air conditioning. And as you can see, as soon as I turned off the AC, the battery voltage, which is the alternator voltage, is going back to the 13.4 level. Now if I turn off the blower, it is going up to 13.8. Now if I run my music system, which already has a subwoofer and a amplifier, so during the time when the bass thumps in, there is a lot of bass and the woofer is drawing power from the amplifier, the voltage was dropping around 12 volts or so. So this is how my voltage monitor going to work, and I'm very much happy with the setup. This is the button I have installed, which turns on and off the voltage monitor. Basically it is a alternator monitor which shows you the voltage going towards your battery while the engine is running. And if I show you the existing, and you can see this is the voltage which is coming after the power regulation. I have four LEDs, currently blue one is off, and that will come up when there 14 volts or something near 14 volts is shown. But this hardly lights up because there is a power regulator, 12 volt to 13 volts power regulator installed in most of the cars. So this light, this blue light, will not come up in most cases in my car. Before wrapping up this video, I waited for a couple of hours and now it is the night time. I wanted to show you guys this night effect of this battery monitor. And as you can see, I've just turned it on. It is showing me 12.2 volts. Now power on my ignition key, the voltage is dropping till 12 volts. As you can see, I tried to crank my car and the voltage dropped, but the car failed to start. Now as the car has started, the voltage has already gone above 13 volts. Voltage stays on 13.4 with the headlights on. On 13 volts. This is my modified meter console of Hyundai Santro in India. Now if I turn off the blower, I am getting 13.8 volts, and if I turn off the lights also, you can see my battery is getting charged because the voltage provided by alternator of this car is giving 14 volts at the moment. So thank you guys for watching my video about installation DC voltage monitor on my car. I hope you like this video. Please subscribe to my channel. Please like this video. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.